Daily Morning Prayer. Saturday, August 31st, 2024. The hour is coming and is now here, when the true worshippers will worship the Father in spirit and truth, for the Father is seeking such people to worship. Let's humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways, O Hashem. We have followed too much to vices and desires of our hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no help in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess their faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for our sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins, and serve you with a quiet mind through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. The mercy of the Lord is everlasting. O come, let us adore him. O be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Be assured that the Lord, he is God. It is he that has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. O go your way into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and speak it of his name. For the Lord is gracious, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures from generation to generation. The mercy of the Lord is everlasting. O come, let us adore him. When I was in trouble, I called upon the Lord, and he hearkened to my calling. Deliver my soul, O Lord, from lying lips and from a deceitful tongue. What reward shall be given or done unto you, O false tongue? Even mighty and sharp arrows with hot burning coals. Woe is me that I am constrained to dwell in Meshech, and to have my habitation among the tents of Kedar. My soul has long dwelt among those who are enemies of peace. I labor for peace, but when I speak to them of it, they make themselves ready for battle. I will lift up my eyes unto the hills, from whence comes my help. My help comes from the Lord, who has made heaven and earth. He will not let your foot be moved, and he who keeps you will not sleep. Behold, he who keeps Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord himself is your keeper, the Lord is your defense upon your right hand, so that the sun shall not burn you by day, neither the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. Indeed, it is he who shall keep your soul. The Lord shall preserve your going out and your coming in from this time forth forevermore. when I was in trouble. But I was glad when they said unto me, we will go into the house of the Lord. Now our feet are standing within your gates, O Jerusalem. Jerusalem is built as a city that is at unity in itself. For there the tribes go up, even the tribes of the Lord, as was decreed for Israel, to give thanks unto the name of the Lord. For there is the throne of judgment, even the throne of the house of David. Oh, pray for the peace of Jerusalem. They shall prosper that love you. Peace be within your walls and plenteousness within your palaces. For my brethren and companions' sakes, I will wish you prosperity. Indeed, because of the house of the Lord our God, I will seek to do you good. Unto you I lift up my eyes, you who are enthroned in the heavens. Behold, as the eyes of servants look to the hand of their masters, and as the eyes of a maiden to the hand of her mistress, even so our eyes wait upon the Lord our God until he show us his favor. Have mercy upon us, O Lord, have mercy upon us, for we have suffered more than enough contempt. Long has our soul suffered the scorn of the wealthy and the spitefulness of the proud. If the Lord himself had not been on our side, now may Israel say, if the Lord himself had not been on our side when men rose up against us, then would they have swallowed us up alive when they were so wrathfully displeased with us? Then the waters would have drowned us, and the torrent gone over us, and the raging waters would have gone clean over us. But praise be the Lord who has not given us over to be prey for their teeth. We escaped like a bird out of the snare of the fowler. The snare is broken, and we have been delivered. Our help is in the name of the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Those who put their trust in the Lord shall be like Mount Zion, which cannot be moved, but stands fast forever. The hills stand about Jerusalem, even as the Lord stands round about his people from this time forth forevermore. For the scepter of the ungodly shall not rest upon the land allotted to the righteous, lest the righteous put forth their hand to do wickedness. Do good, O Lord, unto those who are good, and true of heart. As for those who turn aside to their own wicked ways, the Lord shall lead them away with the evildoers, but peace shall be upon Israel. The Lord overturned the captivity of Zion, then were we like those who dream. Then was our mouth filled with laughter and our tongue with shouts of joy. Then they said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. Indeed, the Lord has done great things for us already, whereof we rejoice. Overturn our captivity, O Lord, as when streams refresh the deserts of the south. Those who sow in tears shall reap with songs of joy. He who goes on his way weeping and bears good seed shall doubtless come again with joy and bring his sheaves with him. Unless the Lord builds a house, their labor is in vain who build it. Unless the Lord keeps the city, the watchman keeps vigil in vain. It is in vain that you rise up early and take rest so late, and eat the bread of toil, for he gives to his beloved sleep. Behold, children are a heritage from the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is a gift that comes from him. Like arrows in the hand of a warrior, so are the children of one's youth. Happy is the man who has his quiver full of them. He shall not be ashamed when he speaks with his enemies in the gate. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the second book of Samuel, beginning with the 18th chapter. The first verse. And David took a court of the people who were with him and appointed over them commanders of thousands and commanders of hundreds. And David sent the people out, a third under the command of Joab, a third under the command of Abishai, the son of Zeruiah, Joab's brother, and a third under the command of Ittai the Gittite. And the king said to the people, I myself will certainly go out with you also. But the people said, you should not go out, for if in fact we flee, they will not care about us. And if half of us die, they will not care about us. But you are worth 10,000 of us. So now it is better that you will be ready to help us from the city. Then the king said to them, whatever seems best to you, I will do. So the king stood beside the gate, and all the people went out by hundreds and thousands. But the king commanded Joab, Abishai, and Ittai, saying, deal gently with the young man Absalom for my sake. And all the people heard when the people commanded all the commanders regarding Absalom. Then the people went out to the field against Israel, and the battle took place in the forest of Ephraim. The people of Israel were defeated there by the servants of David, and the slaughter there that day was great, 20,000 men. The battle there was spread over the whole countryside, and the forest devoured more people that day than the sword devoured. Now Absalom encountered the servants of David. Absalom was riding on his mule, and the mule went under the branches of a massive oak. Then his head caught firmly in the oak. Then his head caught firmly in the oak, and he was left hanging between the sky and earth. While the mule was under him, kept going. When a certain man saw him, he informed Joab and said, behold, I saw Absalom hanging in an oak. Then Joab said to the man who had informed him, so behold, you saw him. Why then did you not strike him there to the ground? And it would have been my duty to give you 10 pieces of silver and a belt. But the man said to Joab, even if I were to receive 1,000 pieces of silver in my hand, I would not put out my hand against the king's son. For in our hearing, the king commanded you, Abishai and Ittai, saying, protect the young man Absalom for me. Otherwise, if I had dealt treacherously against his life, and there is nothing hidden from the king, then you yourself would have avoided me. Then Joab said, I will not waste time here with you. So he took 3 spears in his hand and thrust them through the heart of Absalom while he was still alive in the midst of the oak. And 10 young men who carried Joab's armor gathered around and struck Absalom and killed him. Then Joab blew the trumpet, and the people returned from pursuing Israel, for Joab restrained the people. And they took Absalom and threw him into a deep pit in the forest and erected over him a very large pile of stones. And all Israel fled, each to his own tent. Now Absalom in his lifetime had taken and set up for himself a memorial stone, which is in the king's valley. For he said, I have no son to continue my name. So he named the memorial stone after his own name, and it is called Absalom's Monument to this day. Then Ahimaaz, the son of Zadok, said, please let me run and bring the king news that the Lord has freed him from the land, from the hand of his enemies. But Joab said to him, you are not the man to bring news this day, but you shall bring news another day. However, you shall bring no news this day because the king's son is dead. Then Joab said to the Cushite, "Go tell the king what you have seen." So the Cushite bowed to Joab and ran. However, Ahimaaz, the son of Zadok, said once more to Joab, "But whatever happens, please let me also run after the Cushite." And Joab said, "Why would you run, my son, since you will have no messenger's reward for going?" "But whatever happens," he said, "I will run." So he said to him, "Run." Then Ahimaaz ran by way of the plain and passed the Cushite. Now David was sitting between the two gates, and the watchman went to the roof of the gate by the wall and raised his eyes and looked, and behold, a man was running by himself. So the watchman cried out and told the king, and the king said, "If he is by himself, there is good news in his mouth." And he came nearer and nearer. When the watchman saw another man running, and the watchman said to the gatekeeper and said, "Behold, another man is running by himself." And the king said, "This one also is bringing good news." The watchman said, "I think the running form of the first one is like the running form of Ahimaaz, the son of Zadok." And the king said, "This is a good man, and he is coming with good news." Then Ahimaaz called out and said to the king, "All is well." And he prostrated himself before the king with his face to the ground. And he said, "Blessed is the Lord your God, who has turned over the men who raised your hands against my lord the king." But the king said, "Is it well with the young man Absalom?" And Ahimaaz answered, "When Joab sent the king's servant and your servant, I saw a great commotion, but I did not know what it was." Then the king said, "Turn aside and stand here." So he turned aside and stood still. Then behold, the Cushite arrived, and the Cushite said, "Let my lord the king receive good news, for the Lord has freed you this day from the hand of all those who rose up against you." Then the king said to the Cushite, "Is it well with the young man Absalom?" And the Cushite answered, "May the enemies of my lord the king and all who rise up against you for evil be like that young man." Then the king trembled and went up to the chamber over the gate and wept. And this is what he said as he walked: "My son Absalom, my son, my son Absalom. If only I had died instead of you, Absalom, my son, my son." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glorify the Lord, all you works of the Lord. Praise him and highly exalt him forever. In the firmament of his power, glorify the Lord. Praise him and highly exalt him forever. Glorify the Lord, you angels and all powers of the Lord. O heaven and all waters above the heavens, sun and moon and stars of the sky, glorify the Lord. Praise him and highly exalt him forever. Glorify the Lord, every shower of rain and fall of dew, all winds and fire and heat, summer, winter and summer, glorify the Lord. Praise him and highly exalt him forever. Glorify the Lord, O chill and cold, drops of dew and flakes of snow, frost and cold, ice and sleet. Glorify the Lord, praise him and highly exalt him forever. Glorify the Lord, O nights and days, O shining light and enfolding dark, storm clouds and thunderbolts. Glorify the Lord, praise him and highly exalt him forever. Let the earth glorify the Lord, praise him and highly exalt him forever. Glorify the Lord, O mountains and hills and all that grows upon the earth. Praise him and highly exalt him forever. Glorify the Lord, O springs of water, seas and streams, O whales and all that move in the waters. O bearers of the air, glorify the Lord, praise him and highly exalt him forever. Glorify the Lord, O beasts of the wild and all you flocks and birds. O men and women everywhere, glorify the Lord, praise him and highly exalt him forever. Let the people of God glorify the Lord, praise him and highly exalt him forever. Glorify the Lord, O priests and servants of the Lord, praise him and highly exalt him forever. Glorify the Lord, O spirits and souls of the righteous, praise him and highly exalt him forever. You that are holy and humble of heart, glorify the Lord, praise him and highly exalt him forever. Let us glorify the Lord, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, praise him and highly exalt him forever. In the firmament of his power, glorify the Lord, praise him, and highly exalt him forever. A reading from the Epistle of St. Paul to the Ephesians, beginning with the first chapter, the first verse. I, Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, to the saints who are at Ephesus and are faithful in Christ Jesus, grace to you and peace from God our Father, the Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ, just as he chose us in him through the foundation of the world, that we would be holy and blameless before him. In love he predestined us to adoption as sons and daughters through Jesus Christ to himself, according to the good pleasure of his will, to the praise of the glory of his grace, with which he favored us in the beloved. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our wrongdoings according to the riches of his grace, which he lavished on us. In all wisdom and insight he made known to us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure, which he set forth in him, regarding his plan of the fullness of the times, to bring all things together in Christ, things in the heavens and things on the earth. In him we also have obtained an inheritance, having been predestined according to the purpose of him who works all things in accordance with the plan of his will, to the end that we who were the first to hope in the Christ would be to the praise of his glory. In him you also, after listening to the message of the truth, the gospel of your salvation, having also believed, you were seated in him with the Holy Spirit of the promise, who is the first installment of our inheritance in regard to the redemption of God's own possession, to the praise of his glory. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. O ruler of the universe, Lord God, great deeds are they that you have done, surpassing human understanding. Your ways are ways of righteousness and truth, O King of all the ages. Who can fail to do homage, Lord, and sing the praises of your name? For you only are the Holy One. All nations will draw near and fall down before you, because your just and holy works have been revealed. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Let your continual mercy, O Lord, cleanse and defend your church, and because it cannot continue in safety without your help, protect and govern it always by your goodness through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Almighty God, who after the creation of the world rested from all your works and sanctified a day of rest for all your creatures, grant that we, putting away all earthly anxieties, may be duly prepared for the service of your sanctuary, and that our rest here upon earth may be a preparation for the eternal rest promised to your people in heaven, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you stretched out your arms of love on the hard wood of the cross, that everyone might come within the reach of your saving embrace. So clothe us in your Spirit, that we, reaching forth our hands in love, may bring those who do not know you to the knowledge and love of you, for the honor of your name. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies, that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth and in the age to come life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.